they've been around for a good many years now, and it's not the newest thing in technological advancement, but I never cease to be amazed at the small pocket calculator. Here's a little item that you can go into a cut-rate store and buy for a couple of dollars, and it, in a split second, can compute and give you the answer to a problem that, well, you wouldn't even get your pencil out of the pocket or your mind in gear to solve. Shortcuts. Hi, I'm Bill Pearce. This is Night Sounds. This is an age of shortcuts. No fascination is sharper than our fascination with shortcuts. The kind of world in which we live, instant puddings, instant rice, instant coffee, instant breakfast, fast foods, little wonder that this has permeated all of the life. And I wonder if it's possible to take a shortcut to everything. For instance, is instant wholeness possible? I've entitled our program tonight, Shortcut. Reminds me of a song we got involved in many years ago as the Melody Four Quartet. We did a concert up in Minneapolis and used this song, and I'm talking with Glenn Jorian, the second tenor in our quartet, in the middle of the concert, about how this little song got started. But the overtones are tremendous and have quite a bit to do with what we're into tonight. So let's join the quartet in progress here. We're having a little dialogue before the song in question comes to be. Okay?
Well, Glenn, since we're reminiscing on this album, do you remember a trip to a recording studio in Chicago back there when we were sort of getting together some arrangements and ideas of what we could do? And this next song brings back a few little memories.
It really does. Actually, Springs and the next one we're going to do are two songs we did back-to-back on a little 45. It was the first cut. And I know I was coming home from a Songs of the Night recording or broadcast late Sunday night. We had a session Monday. And I was thinking, what in the world can we do to make this a little different? And so just kind of put together a little basic format and got downtown. And I talked to Dick about it a minute. And with a little guitar and string bass, we kind of walked through a real easy tempoed song. Just sits back in the saddle, and one of you guys might want to help us a little bit, you know. All right.
The fellow named Dick he was talking about was Dick Anthony, and he right. was our first accompanist arranger. And somebody suggested, Pierce, why don't you do something
you
sort of like
off,
a walking
yeah.
bass, like, it's not an easy road. Well, it's not an easy road. Well, it's not an easy road.
It's not an easy guide us.
Oh, it's hard.
For Quartet in Concert.
All right, thank you.
And it occurs to me that that was the swan song, our final concert after 37 years on the road and in recording with the original four guys. I guess that's got to be a record in and of itself. But what we're interested in tonight is the text of that particular recording. It's not an easy road. The fastest way, the way of the shortcut, isn't always the best way. We're fascinated with shortcuts, though, aren't we? Over here, in a few moments, we're going to play a recording on a compact disc. What a relief after queuing up one of the old vinyl recordings on a turntable over here to be able to push a button and have this sound come forth totally distortion-free. This is a shortcut that's worth something, along with other advancements. But not everything is accomplished the easiest way. The song we just heard said it's not an easy road we're called to follow. We don't want to know if it'll work. We want to know if it will work now, quickly. And I think sometimes we need to face up the fallacy of this mindset. It was Charles F. Kettering who once said, if you buy a violin today, you can't expect to give a concert in Carnegie Hall tomorrow. This is essentially what Jesus talked about in the Sermon on the Mount in Matthew chapter 7. The Phillips translation reads, do you pick a bunch of grapes from a thorn bush or figs from a clump of thistles? A bad tree cannot bear good fruit. And I guess he might as well have said, as you don't pick a bunch of grapes from a thorn bush, you don't pick grapes from a vine that you planted only yesterday. So despite our fascination with instant products and shortcuts, there is no instant wholeness of person. And we need to realize that wholeness is not inevitable. I just set my clock a few moments ago and was reminded that the tick of a clock and the turn of a calendar assures us that we are growing older, but we're not necessarily growing whole. The aging process and the maturing process don't necessarily walk hand in hand down the road of life. When we fail to take responsibility for the process of wholeness along the road, time will beat us to the punch. The opportunities pass, the doors close, roadblocks are set up, and what might have been becomes just a ghost. And as we're fascinated with shortcuts, we're intent on goal setting and goal reaching. Goals are important and necessary for growth. But you can't hold up a package and say, this is it. When you get to this point, you will be a whole person. We've indoctrinated our kids and youth with an elaborate set of fixed beliefs, stuffed their heads with vast bodies of knowledge and advice. But doing this alone is not the entire answer. In his book, Be Your Whole Self, Maxie Dunham asked the question, is to be a Bible-reading Christian a goal? And being this, does it make one mature? We need to see Bible reading not as a goal of the Christian life, but as a resource for Christian growth. Prayer the same way. Is this a goal or a resource? Well, it's a resource, a channel of power that enables us to grow. Worship is the same way. A person isn't necessarily whole because he worships. But worship is an essential part of the growing process. Tonight's music will be a commentary on not only goal setting but shortcuts. I'm always careful when I talk about the prayer of Jesus in the Garden of Gethsemane, because at this particular point of his ministry, he was attacked as never before, because he was making the decision to go to the cross or not. And in a sense, he asked God, is there another way out of this? Is there another way to accomplish what is to be done without going to the cross? In other words, is there a shortcut that would be acceptable to you? And he said, Father, if it's your will, let this cup pass from me. Nonetheless, not my will, but yours be done. So he didn't take the shortcut. He accepted the cross. If he had taken a shortcut, well, I certainly wouldn't be on the air with this kind of a message. There would be no reason to go to church. There wouldn't be any salvation. The Bible would be another dusty book on a shelf. Jesus didn't take a shortcut. Joyce Landorf sings a song now with the title Shortcut Home. She follows some tough things along the way. Let's follow her in the thought process of this song, Shortcut Home.
Remember when I was so young, so full of faith and coy? The world all free from pain and doubt, a kaleidoscope of joy. Then there came that little pain, the one I hardly knew. An ache, a knife, then silent screams, and now my life seems. I wanna come home and be with you, dear Jesus. I wanna come home and see your face. I wanna come home and be with you, dear Jesus. For I'm sick and tired of this lonely, painful place. I know stop my days, leave family and friends, but something snapped, the pain has won, so this must be the end. I'm coming home. Should I really try to stay? Could you have meaning in such pain? Oh God, I want to fly away. I want to come home and be with you, dear Jesus. I want to come home. I wanna come home and be with you, dear Jesus. For I'm sick and tired of this lonely, painful place. I'm coming home to be with you. There's nothing left to give, or can I live my pain for you? Dear Lord, I'll try to live, so I guess I'll stay just one more day and handle what time will bring. I'll live my life and give again, but this one song I'll steal. I wanna come home and be with you, dear Jesus. I wanna come home and see your face. I wanna come home and be with you, dear Jesus. For I'm sick and tired of this lonely, painful place. I'm sick of this place, and I'm tired of the race, and I can't stand the pace. I wanna come home and be with you.
Joyce Landorf. The song Shortcut Home. I'm tired of the rat race. I wanna come home right now. Somebody said that to me the other day. I can recall even speaking some years ago with a person who was suicidal, who said, I want to go home and be with the Lord right now. I don't want to go through any more suffering. I don't want to endure any more hassles, abuse, sickness, pain. I'm tired of it all. Remember the old song, Stop the World, I Want to Get Off? It's the same idea. Sort of like the butterfly in the cocoon story, you know how that worked out. You can't help a butterfly in his struggle to get out of the cocoon. If you do, you'll kill him. In the process is part of the healing of the answer. So let's not ask too hasty a deliverance. Let's not always look for the shortcut to wholeness. The touch of Jesus is what made people whole. So if we're going to be whole persons, it doesn't exist or revolve around a PhD degree on the wall, a high-grade performance, a big salary, a big name. Wholeness means to reconcile yourself to the God who loves you and has a purpose for your life. I was a failure most of the years of my life, and it wasn't until I reached a very dark night of my soul that I was desperate. And I dropped all my so-called expertise in anything and said, Lord, take hold of my life. I don't know where I'm going. But I sense that I'm going downward. Well, no miracles happened at the moment. I felt no particular dramatic impulses, no bolts out of the blue. But in time, he began to lead me to the right people at the right moment. Consequently, here we are tonight. I never planned a career in radio or the performing arts. I was a jazz trombone player. That's all I could do. But when the Lord God takes a hold of a life, he can bring a wholeness to it that we perhaps never anticipated in 1,000 years. Let's for a moment go back to that thought that we were into a few minutes ago, when Jesus knelt in that agonizing moment in Gethsemane. There was a song written some years ago, which we've played before, but which I believe bears repeating. There was no easier way.
Why can't I live my life without losing it? Why can't I grow without pay? Why can't I live for you, Lord, without dying? There must be an easier way.
There was no easier way for you. There was no easier thing you could do. The cost of my life.
No Easier Way, the Don Wurton Chorus, and soloist Brian Felton. Before we take our leave of you tonight, I want to read a bit of verse from the pen of Ann Weems. With the title The Unexpected, she wrote, "Even now, we simply do not expect to find a deity in a stable. Somehow the setting is all wrong. The swaddling clothes too plain, the manger too common for the likes of a savior, the straw unelegant, the animals reeking and noisy, the whole scene too ordinary for our taste, and the cast of character is no better. With the possible exception of the kings, who among them is fit for this night? The shepherds, certainly too crude, the carpenter too rough, the girl too young. And the baby, whoever expected a baby? Whoever expected the advent of God in a helpless child? Had the Messiah arrived in a blazing light of glory, of a legion of angels wielding golden swords, the whole world could have been conquered for Christ right then and there. And we and the church, to say nothing of the world, wouldn't have so much trouble today. Even now, we simply do not expect to face the world armed with love. When we bow at the altar of proficiency or of expediency or of the shortcuts, the instant things, we are equipped to perform tasks but not to relate to persons. There is no instant wholeness. There are pitfalls into which we can stumble. We make our choice. We set out for a succession of new births, not knowing where we're going, but certain that whatever our quest for wholeness entails, it will be better than the unwholeness that we now may know. Lord God, we thank you that you allow us to go through times of stress, times of testing, times of trouble to make us whole. Again, may we not ask too hasty a deliverance from the pain that we may be enduring, or the struggle that we're into, the fact that we don't understand, we don't have an instant answer, we can't find a shortcut around this situation. Please help us to accept your will and your way, which is a way of love and compassion and of ultimate strengthening and wholeness for each and every one of us. We've found that your way is the best way, Lord, and we want to go your way. I pray that you will help that one who is seeking wholeness and reason for life and some sort of symmetry to his or her existence. May they know the quiet and beautiful power of your Spirit right now. In the name of Jesus, amen. Thank you for being there, for being my friend, for considering what was said and played tonight. If we can be of extra help to you as we're able, our mailing address is Nightsounds, Wheaton, Illinois, 60189. And until next time, may you be well on the way to wholeness as you yield yourself to Christ. A good day to you tomorrow, and until we meet again, a peaceful good night.